So I've known Russ Taff or been listening to him since he was in the Imperials all the way back in, you know, I was in seventh grade, and he released a solo album, self-titled solo album in 1989 that became the obsession of myself and my little group of friends. We were all going through all that, you know, pubescent drama and unrequited love and, you know, teen angst. And this guy just, it sounded like he was having a breakdown right in front of your ears. There was something so compelling about not even the songs necessarily, but the way that he sang. And you can't ever compare Russ Taff to any other vocalist. If you ever heard him sing, there's nobody on the planet that sings like Russ Taff. I doubt there ever will be. The probably without question, the most soulful, spirited voice that I've ever heard. But that album became very, very precious to me and Christy, who was my buddy at the time, my wife now, and all of our friends. And he admitted later that he was struggling with a life-threatening alcohol addiction at the time. So I think it took a lot of guts for him to record that album and be as transparent as he was on it. His follow-up was kind of like this just a confessional almost. It was called The Way Home. It came out in 1989, a couple years later. And all the songs are about failure and regret and brokenness and ultimately about hope. And you kind of felt like listening to it, like he's going to be okay. And the first track, The Winds of Change, it has just stuck with me. I don't even listen to him really that much anymore, but I've covered this particular song hundreds of times because I feel like I've just grown up with it. And in so many ways, it speaks to things that I've experienced now that I didn't really understand those lyrics whenever I was 19 years old. But now as I'm 50, I look back and think, man, this, I could have written this song. So I can't do his voice justice, but I really wanted to get a decent recording of it down and some video. So this is Russ Taff's The Winds of Change.